ankle and then him not walking forwards. The most important thing is the walking forwards. The walk is a part of the simple change. We have to show a direct transition from canter to walk, forward, nice medium walk, and then into canter again. Right, do you want to just go and do a couple? If you need to refresh the canter at all, then that's fine. And what I mean by refresh the canter, it could be a little bit on and back, you know, forward a bit just to get the spring and get him in front of the leg. Good. Very nice. And you see the way he comes into the upward transition, really comes up off the floor, and it shows it sort of grows underneath you. Once again, when you're ready, just make sure you've got that right leg. Doesn't get too far back. Okay, not in front of you. So again, she felt that, I saw it, she knows exactly what was wrong. So she wants to be able to ask him to walk at exactly when she wants it. Good. You know, he's a pro at these. You know, he has had 10s for those simple changes. He's a good one to demonstrate good simple changes. Nice forward. Make sure as you come back you don't get the neck short and you don't also get him too low in the neck. Just there, I felt as she came back, he got a little bit low. Okay, let's try a trot and see what happens. Doesn't matter what goes wrong. Right, now, I don't know whether everybody saw that. Walk again. When she asked for trot, watch how much he sped up in the walk and how the walk accelerated before he trotted. So as far as she's concerned, he's not in front of my leg. He's not going off the leg. So she chases him. But actually, it's about the fact that he speeds up in the walk. So I want you to concentrate. That's it. I'm not letting him speed up in the walk.